Greetings and welcome back everyone to another episode of Prison Architect. And as you can remember, we finally completed the 200 prisoners in our prison by filling up these cells here. We also got some money and apparently we have a daily cash flow. So, I don't know how long this daily cash flow is going to last, nor do I know how long that the money we have is going to last either. So, oh, someone just got released. Nice. So, what I was thinking about doing was at least attempting to start the high-risk area, which we are getting some money from, and we should be able to get down with, be able to get down the amount of people to put in. Now, I do see that there are a few of these open in here. So I don't think I want to add too much of any more, but what I do want to do is just double check our programs again, like we always do, because right when we start it, we always find that ones have people interested and some don't. Actually, I'm just going to keep going. Nope. And those are not going to be able to do it. Just in case we might miss something or people are interested in a class. See, like sometimes there's two people when I hit start, sometimes there isn't. So it kind of cheats the system, I guess, when you redo it that way. No one in there. So, and then parole hearing should be all open anyway. Spiritual guidance. There shouldn't be anybody else in there. Carpentry apprenticeship, general education, behavioral therapy, and guard taser certification. So we'll go back up, and there are some guards to certify for taser. I really don't want to lose all the money for that right at this point in time, so I'm not going to start that just yet. Behavioral therapy, looks like no one is interested in it. General education qualification, there are two people interested, so we will do one. Carpentry apprenticeship, nobody, so we will stop that, and that should be everything. So that's all redone there, and it is snowing outside. So, what should we do? I think at this point, it's time to start designing this prison. We'll let this one go since we have income coming in 12 hours, so that should put us up enough. We're gonna force the income of the maximum security prisoners, and we'll also take into account how many we have here, which is 30. So we already have to take into account that we have 30 in order to Why? Now I'm gonna waste all of this money. For real? Well, okay. I suppose that's a thing. Well, we'll have to go to materials, brick wall. Rebuild that, rebuild this, that's fine. And then we will redesignate this as cell. No, I guess we can't. Oh, we can't even put it in because it has to be enclosed. And then I won't even, do I even want to put the fence back in? Like, do I even need the fence? Because I don't really even need the fence. It's another spot for them to dig through, though. So I guess I will put the fence back in. So I'll put it there just to have it, and then they can get on with that. So I guess while they're refilling the hole in the wall, which all the workers should be able to do right now because they don't have anything to do, we will work on planning out and designing this whole next thing here. So we're going to start with the simple pathways. And it's definitely going to come down and be a nice, simple, straight down path. And I think we're going to make it down from here. And we'll make a nice big square around everything with one space. So right there. And the two on this side. And the two on this side. So what I want to do differently is put visitation here. Because then that way they don't have to walk as far. They can come right into the center, down, and right here. So what we're going to do is we're going to do walls right away, and it's going to be right here along this. like that. So I'll probably get rid of this pathway and move it over two. So like this, we can get rid of that right there. And we'll have something like that as a pathway. And then we'll have an entrance here and an entrance there. No, sorry. Entrance there. And that should be enough for the visitation tables. Actually, we'll go... Oh, we don't have visitation, so I gotta do visitation booth. And that should be enough. No, there needs to be a space on either side. So I have to extend this up by two. Or I could just push it out by one. Because there's nobody really gonna go down here anyway. So what I'll probably do is extend it out by one. Like this. And then just eliminate this inside part here. That way there's space to walk on it. And we'll do it from right there. And then we just have to redo this part here. And the pathway will go right there. Just like that. And then we'll extend this out like that. Get rid of that one and that one. And that should be good. And then of course we'll put our doors there. And right here. Now it should give us enough room for the amount that we want. So, visitation booth. So that's room for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So that's 9. How many people? 87 families waiting. Oh, right, because we have visitation off. How many do we have in here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 8. 12, 14. So we're gonna keep about the same here. So we will adjust said building in order to do 14. So that's, they're 2 by 2. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So that's 7 there. So that's 14 long, and then we'll do 14 down here, which is gonna be a longer building. But it won't take up as much room, and we'll have more space for other things. So we will do that right there. So that should... No, not walls. That should be our full length. So that should be 28. Yes, and then we'll put a wall there. And that'll be our visitation, which should take up a little less room, hopefully. Now that it's just kind of one little path down the other way, and then we will extend this out like so. So that way it's a nice gradual down, and we'll do one here, one at that end, and one in the center-ish. That looks about center, so we have 10 and 10 there. There we go, so that's our visitation area for that. Now we need our main cell area. And then we need our main canteen area. And I'm thinking we should try and do something different. We're going to do something different than these. Because these are high risk. So I'm thinking almost if we do... Well, I mean, that's not really going to work if we do a giant cell block here. Well, you know what? Maybe it would be cool to do a giant cell block there because we haven't done anything. And then run a pathway down the center. And then we can do different things in each of the middle of these. Or we can build it into sections. That way we have it split, so that way we're not spending, oh, I don't know, freaking 28,000 on the building. Oh, and there's a little paper here. A little notebook page. Placing objects. Nice. That's cool. Sweet. Alright. So I think we'll divide this building up. Back in my planning here. This is 81 divided by 3. It is divisible by 3 because 81. Hang on. We can figure this out. It's 27. All right, so 27, so right there is that point. And 27 here is this point, so this should be 27, 25, and 25. Or it can be 26 and 26. Is that how this is going to work? 26, 25, 26. Okay, you know what? Whatever. That's good enough. I'm okay with that. So we could divide these into threes and do like a little cell section each there. And we can build them here. And then we can do one large canteen that is space 1, 2, space, nope, down here. We can do a larger kitchen area that is probably that. A very long kitchen would be kind of cool. And then we can do all of our bigger things down at the bottom. Well, actually, we can check out how big these will be, because we need some extra space for the heating area. So that'll probably be something like a break off here. Like that, we'll have our heater. And then same thing on this side. We'll have a little break off for the heater. And then this top one, we will do it in the center-ish. That's not wide enough. There we go. We have a little area for the heater in the center. And then we'll have pathways running down, I think, the middle here, because that's 1, 2, 3. So then the cells can be like so. And the same thing down this side. We can have a right there, so it would be like, actually like that. We'll put the door separate. This is too small. That's better. And then we can have a cell right there. And that'll match. Perfect. Right? Oh, this one's too long. That's sad. Well, I'm gonna make this 3. And then this can just be a little extra wide. That way this is all even. And then this can run straight down to here. And we'll do that. And then this one could run straight down here. Goes there, right? Yep, it goes right there. And that'll be cool. And then we'll make entrances like so. This will be a cool one. And then we'll have a shower probably in the middle. Probably just a long shower like this. And then we'll have an entrance there and there. And that can be showers in the center, and then all down here can just be cells. That should work. Just 4x5 cells that go all the way down, and probably is going to end up uneven, and I'm going to be really upset. Yep, it's going to be uneven. So we're going to have some extra cells that are going to be a little bit bigger than before. Well, no, they're not going to be bigger than before, they're just going to be graded cells. And this does not fit on this side, which is a shame. So let me just put these in, and then I'll decide how I want to do the shower. So that's going to be that. So actually, we could just take this bottom part and make this bottom part the shower entrance down here. That way we'll have more room. And then we'll just make these like this. Spread these out. There's going to be 1, 3, 1 at the bottom, which I'm okay with doing one graded cell at the bottom. Uh-oh, what's going on here? Okay, it's the maximum security thing. Everyone's just kind of going rampant. It's all the maximum security people. You know what? They're going to have to deal with it, because I'm working on their maximum security thing, and it's going to take me a little while. I apologize for it taking a while. So how many people are in here? This is a question. Not there. And then we can gauge how big the shower area is. If we made it too big or too small, that's not good. It came up twice. Yeah, there we go. Yep. So people are going to start putting their hands up because the armed guard's getting tired of it. And 2 deaths. Yeah, are you still going to kick? Oh, they knocked the guard unconscious. And one of them picked up a taser. But they're mostly all subdued after, yeah, we're going to tase them. And now it's 4 against a couple. So they're going to get some solitary time. Alrighty. Anyway. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. So 13, 13 is 26. So we almost have enough for the rest of the maximum security prisoners to come over. But how many do we have in here? 36. So 15 and 15 is not enough. Wait, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 13. Yeah, so each side and each side. Ah, so this is perfect. So this setup is fine. How we have it like this. And they'll just come in straight down the center, and then we'll make entrances on the canteen the same way. So we'll have it like that, and entrances like this into the larger canteen, which the canteen is going to cost us a bigger amount, so we'll do the same thing on this side. And this is where our entrance will be, and this is, yeah, 1, 2, 3. So this is where our other entrance will be as well on this one, right here. And straight across from that will be another entrance to the canteen. And then this will be big enough for, hopefully, what we want to do. So now we just have to... Oh, this is different because it's on the left side now. Hmm. And it's one bigger. Oh. This is sad. Well, maybe since it's one bigger, I'll take the center of 12, which is 6 and 6... So 6 is here, so it'll go there, like that, and that can be the center of that water heater, and the same thing will be on this one. It'll go in the center after these get changed to that. This entrance is going to go there, and this one's going to get changed to the same thing. That entrance will go there. Like this. And then straight across will go the entrances to the canteen as well. So since the canteen's gonna be long, I think we'll only just need like one giant row of tables. So that should be okay. But we're gonna do this entrance up here. There. And it looks like it's up here. And this one looks like it's going here. This one looks like it's going there. And then that will be the entrance for this. And these are going to have to be different since it's one longer. So I'm going to have to rethink how I want to put the... Well, it's one longer this way, so the shower is going to be wider. So I can't really put cells down here because that's too small. Yeah, I can't really do... This is wasted space, which kind of stinks. So I'm kind of upset with that, of this wasted space right here. I could put some phones in down here, if I really wanted to. That would be something kind of neat. But these should all fit the regular 4x5 cells on this side. There we go, and then these will all go down until there. Same thing with this side. We'll go down. And I'm just going to design one. That way we'll know we can mirror it on the other side. After we get done with the thing. Yeah, because these are 1, 2, 3, 4. So this almost has to come in one unless we make this the shower. Here. Like so. And we could put a wall there, and a wall there to put some across here. So I don't know how many that will be, but then this is going to have to go in rows this way with 4x5. Is it going to fit? And of course it's one off. Why else would you think otherwise? So there's going to have to be one either like that, or one bigger cell in the middle. Which I think I can live with just having the double wall here. I think I'm okay with that. Because then down here, we can put in this, and then it'll be the same. It'll have a double wall. Wasting some space, which is unfortunate, but it's not the end of the world, I suppose. And then we can have these, like this, and then that should be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5 is this one, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, so 13 as well. So this should be 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27. Yeah, we should be good. We should be good on this. So that building is good. It's going to have this double wall in the middle. I'm okay with that. Just because it is what it is. So it's going to be 26, 26, 26. So 26 times 3. 26 times 3 is 78. 78 divided by 8 is 9.75. So all we need are 12 tables. So 12 tables, and we'll do a space of 1 around them. Just to save some space. So 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12 is good enough. But that doesn't even reach halfway down here. So could we either leave this space as it is? Well, maybe we should do 2 spaces between them. So I guess we'll skip 2. And we'll skip 2 again to give us 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, oh, come on, 10, 11, 12. So that's 12 there, and it's almost full, so I'm thinking we could fit another, probably we can fit another cell block, or, well, yeah, because 12 is over. So that means we can go, because we went 10 over, so we can fit another maybe 26 thing in here. So actually, if we take this and get rid of this one, we can make another whole cell block in this area here. Make it into another 26-person cell block. And then we can see where all the other rooms fit in time. Because how many tables do these have? These have 12 tables. And this small amount of kitchen space is good enough. And that's going to be a 11 by 21. So 11 by 21 should fit in the same area as something smaller. Because 11 by 21 is 231. So 231 would fit in something like this. So it would only need half that space. But we could do, plus we need more room for the serving tables, just so people can come in and get them. But 12 tables would be okay, and we could do another section. We'd have to get rid of these two, and then we'd have to take this wall here and push it right down there, right on this one, and then do an exit down at the bottom. Just like the other ones. And I think that would be okay. Because then we could just take the wall. And we don't even need... the kitchen can kind of go like this. And come like this. And then we can do some extra tables for it. So here's 12. 11 by 21. And the same amount of space, 11 by 21, will fit in a 6 by 37. 222. That was pretty close to it. Because there are some extra spaces that we don't use in here. Like a lot of this extra space we don't use. So I think that would be okay. And we could put some tables in here. The two that we're missing. And then we could put doors here. And then in between here and here, to kind of make space for some serving tables, we can put some phones out here where there's extra space. So I think that'll be good. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Put a door. Oh, that's a wall. Boop. And objects are still... Oh, I want to be in wall. Replace with the wall. All right, so 5. We'll do 5. And 5 again. 5. And 5 again. We'll do a wall there. And then we should be able to do 5 and 5 again. Perfect. And then we'll do a door on the side just in case. And we'll do some doors down here where the sinks will be. So we'll do cookers like that and a fridge. Some cookers here that should fit. Yes, they do. And then we'll do a line of fridges here. Like that, so we'll go all along this wall, along there, all along this wall, and along here. So that's 2, 2, 2, and then a fridge. That way it'll end, and we'll do fridges here, and then all back here we'll do some sinks. And we're just seeing where they fit in to see where we want to make our entrances. And this should be perfect, and then we definitely need to make some space for our heater to go in. So we could do a door there, door here. We'll get rid of this sink and do a door there, and we'll get rid of this sink and do a door there. And then can we fit another sink in between here and here? Oh, no, it's gonna be off. That's fine. I can make it look kinda like this. That should be enough sinks. And then we'll do some doors exiting down there, and this will be an exit here as well. Just like that. Cool. So, to get this started, it would be 17 plus 11. So that would be 30-odd grand in order to get, which we are going to get 30, oh, relatively soon. It's almost time for them to show up. And then we could fit the 30 maximum security prisoners that we have, plus we're getting more income from them being here. And then once we accept the other prisoners, we should be able to get on our way. But we need the money to furniture. Wow. Drawing a blank. No idea. So, this cell block will be one there. And then the rest of our rooms down here, we're gonna have to leave 1, 2, 3, 4. And then there can be stuff all in here on both sides. And don't forget, we didn't put in our power and stuff yet. So we need to not forget about that. And I was hoping we should put it up here. Or we could take this whole space that isn't going to be used, because you're going to enter through up here anyway. So we could take this wall, come down here, and build a little spot that's kind of like this. And then we can have our 5x5 here, and the 3 here. That way it's kind of off in the middle, and it's not really impeding too much of anything. I mean, yeah, it's kind of going in here between those two, but that's whatever. I'm not too worried about that. And then we can build this. And then what else could go in? I mean, that's going to cut off walkway going straight down in here into our center thing, which ruins the whole dividing everything. I'm actually not sure how I feel about that. Because that is kind of cheating. Because it's ruining them going down through here and kind of dividing it by the whole gate. Not gate, but just the whole walls thing. Let's try and see if we can design it without it. So what do we need? A common room. For sure. The common room can go in here. And how big is this common room down here? This is 16 by 12. So 13 by 17. Perfect. Boom. Common room. Done. We'll just put C R. Oh. Well. C R. There we go. Perfect. And then it's not a centered thing. Oh yeah, we can do 6 and 6. That's right. So 6 and 6. So there. And we won't do that, we'll just do that. And then exits down here. So that's our common room. Laundry for sure. Our laundry is pretty decent. It's a 5 by 14. So we will do, this is 18, so we will do 5 by 18. And it's gotta be a single door. So we'll do that. And that'll be our laundry. So we'll make an L for laundry. Then what else do we need? We need an infirmary, which I think the infirmary will put here. And this infirmary is 13 by 8. So we will go for 13 by 8. Which I'm doing this because the morgue will go in the back. So this will be our back room for the morgue, and I'll have one, and I'll have some slabs around here, which will be fine, and then this will be the infirmary. So we'll label that as I. And there'll be just an entrance up top here in the center. So that's our infirmary. We definitely need that. A classroom. Well, what else is more important? Parole, protective custody. So many rooms to think about. there's actually way too many rooms to think about. Look, we're getting a lot of money. Wow, actually, we have 39,000. Let's do this. Let's do this. These are these buildings are... These two are not confirmed. This can be extra space. Because we're going to have to fit it all down here. So let's build the confirmed space here and here. Those are confirmed spaces. So let's build those. And it's going to require an entrance, so we'll put a jail door there and there. That should be good for now. So parole will do off on a... Actually, could we technically just do it right here? No, it wouldn't be wide enough. Unless we totally blank this out. Don't allow a walkway here, because they can walk through the cells, and cheat this as a building, like that. And kind of get rid of this. Oh, we can make this an entrance. And then we make something here and something here. That we could cheat. I mean, technically they can just walk up through this, through the cell block, instead of outside. Which I'm okay with. I'm not too upset with that. I'm okay with cheating and putting a thing here. Because then we can do our power. We can do our power there. And the water there. And that's our... And that's our utility room. Aww. I need walls. And then in here could be security, because they're all going to come out here and go in here. So this could be security, which would be nice. We need a staff room too. That's the other thing. We need a lot of rooms for something down here. So we might have to cancel this whole bottom part, because what are they going to walk down here to the bottom for anyway? Nothing. So this is kind of pointless to have this bottom part here. Because when we expand out, then they can walk down past the bottom of it. So the only thing that would be useful for would be to make these rooms larger. Or we could divide them in half. So that's security, which is fine because it kind of connects all those cells. So let's do parole, which is usually a 6x6. Is that right? Because it's a 5x5 area or a 4x4 area. I think it's a 5x5. That's 6x6. I'm pretty sure it's just 5x5 for parole. Parole. It's gonna be 5x5. Yeah. Got that. Parole's going to be 5x5. That's 4x4. So one extra. Parole, 5x5. Perfect. P. For parole. We'll do it in that kind of P. So now what can go down here? What is the classroom size? 11x7. 11x10x5. So we could do that and do the classroom. So that's a 10x7. This is a 10x11x7. Is that what this one is? 11x7? 10x7. Well, we'll extend that down to here. This one will have to have an entrance down there. But it only has one main door. So we'll do that. This one only has one main door here. We'll do two doors. Well, no, that door is pointless. And they're building all this down here. So this will be a classroom. So this is... this will be in objects CL. We need a cleaning cupboard, which could be... which we could do that at right here for the cleaning cupboard. Let's do a CC for cleaning cupboard. And then this could be a little extra room down here. But I think that's all we'll do for... well, I don't know if I want to do that. Well, let's plan the rest of this off in this episode. That way we can get right to building in the next one. We need protective custody, shop, kennel. We still need a lot of things. Staff room. So security, power plant management. This is still extra. Technically, we could use this space if we really want to. But I'd really like it as sales just because it would make our income a lot higher. So let's do staff room. So staff room is going to be fairly large. Because this is 13x4, plus a 4x15, oops. So that means we're going to have to make it pretty decent. That's probably going to be our staff room, right here. This is going to be our staff room. That's an R. Get over it. R, I guess. Staff room. There we go. It'll have a little cut in it, that way we can make some toilets on the other side. It'll be perfect. Okay. Protective custody. Protective custody should be here. And this time it's going to be nice cells. And these are going to be about that big. All down this way. Like that. There's one larger one. Or we can do that, extend this room down here like so. That way there's room for solitary if they ever get into a jam. So 3x5, 3x5. This one's also 3x5. Okay, just making sure. So something like that. That'll be protective custody. That's pretty obvious. So now I'm kind of eliminating the fact of going behind here. So this staff room can be bigger to there. And so can this classroom. This classroom can be bigger to here. We'll make the entrance on this side. So staff room entrance there. That entrance there. What else are we missing? A kennel, which doesn't have to be too big. Maybe we'll put an entrance back here. Or let's do some of the more... so we have a classroom. We have this. A psychiatric office on the same side as the infirmary. What we'll do is we will do that. And this should be enough for beds in here. We'll do like a line of twos and twos. Actually, I'll get rid of this I. So two like that. Six should be okay. There's six down there, and we haven't had an issue. So office there. And there, this will be an O. And this is somehow an M for Morg. There we go, M for Morg. This building is almost done. So that's protective custody. Pretty obvious there. We have that, we have that, we have that. A holding cell, I'm not too worried about. A chapel. Next thing, 11 by 7. So we'll do, since it's longer, we'll do it by 6, I'm thinking. And since no one's going back here, we can actually make it even longer. Or we can have just one walk around this way and they can go around the back. I'm not too much of a fan of that. So we'll just make these longer and one entrance only. Or we'll do two side entrances. So like one there and one there like that. The library will also have two entrances and it'll go all the way back here like that. The infirmary will be a little bigger. So this will move down. The office will move down. I'll move those down later. And then this hole back here will be larger. Because we can always extend like a little thing down the center here and make buildings kind of like this. Like that. And do buildings on the side. This can be our chapel. Because why not? This can be our CH, which I'll do in this. So C, CH. Yeah, that's an H. Close enough. CH. And that's good. Kennel, shop. Kennel and shop. So a shop can go there, I'm thinking. We'll do one bigger. So this is a shop. Yeah. That's a really shitty S. It's a very crappy S. We'll just do like that. That way we know that that's the shop. There we go. Shop. What else have we got? This. We have that. Yep. Classroom. Yep. We have the classroom. We don't have a holding cell. We have protective custody. We have a chapel. We don't have a kennel. The kennel will probably go up here. It'll be a little thin. So something like that. No, we want one more wall down. This could be our kennel. So we'll do that as a K for kennel. And then that wall can go, that door can go there. Actually, it'll go there. Because then all the dog cages will be along this wall. So we have our staff room, which is fine. We have our laundry, we have our kennel, we have our shop. Do we have our library? This is laundry. Or this will be library, depending on how it's set up. Probably. Does library have a minimum size requirement? Because this is only 4 wide. Does library have a 5 minimum? Library does have a 5 minimum. What about laundry? Laundry does not have a 5 minimum, so laundry will go there. So laundry is going there. So library will have to go in here, which what is the size of this one? This one is 5 by 14, so 6 by 13, it's a little smaller, so we'll go 7. And that'll be our, this'll be our library. L, and I'll just put little bookshelves in here to make sure that we remember that that's library. What else? Common room we have. That's good enough. We don't have a holding cell. This will be cell blocks now, since we already know. We have that. We have parole. We only need one parole, because high risk doesn't really do that much. What is this? Mail room. Hey, I knew we forgot something. This is too big for a mail room. So we will do something like that for our mail room. So we'll do an M, like so, for mailroom. Alright, so check. 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 We have this. This is going to hopefully... Hopefully our staff room, kitchen, and stuff will be able to be supplied by this. If not, we have extra space here. We have protective custody. We have a chapel. We have a kennel. We have a shop. We don't have a holding cell. I'm okay with that. For now, we have an infirmary. We have a canteen. We have a common room. We have laundry. We have library. We have shop. We have kennel. We don't have a workshop. That's fine. Because usually it's all the low-risk workers that do the workshop stuff anyway. I think that is it for planning. It's been a longer episode than usual, but I wanted to plan it all out in one go, so that way we have it. We have $7,000 in the bank, so enough to start furnishing and moving these maximum security prisoners over to here once we get the money for it. So we will be doing that. So once we accept all the high-risk prisoners, we will lock this open. And lock this open. It's going to require a ton of money, but we are finally starting on our high-risk section, which is going to be fantastic. If you have any comments on the design, or maybe something we should change with the design, let me know in the comments below, and I will see you guys on the next episode.